Good morning, Christ-Nagarians.
You are watching Tech Talk,
co-powered by Computer Department of Christ-Nagar School.
I am Rachel.
And I am Madison.
And we are your hosts for the show.
Rachel, I was thinking, isn't it important that nowadays, especially during the pandemic period, we need to aim towards creating awareness and driving digital literacy to underserved communities worldwide?
Madison, it's been so long since the pandemic began. And is it just now that you had this idea?
Oh, come on, Rachel. Not this time. Stop making fun of me.
I'm making fun of you? Seriously, is that what you think?
But still, it's a point to be noted. And don't be jealous, huh? Because you couldn't come up with this idea before.
Haha. Well then, my friend, this idea was thought by great minds many years ago. And that is exactly why we celebrate December 2nd, that is today, as World Computer Literacy Day.
Oh, okay. Rachel, but could you imagine a world without computers, phones, Instagram, or your favorite movie shows?
As if you could imagine a world without your PS4s, PC games. Don't even get me started.
True. Well, in a way, if you think about it, all these gadgets were used for entertainment purpose only until last year.
Yes, and nowadays, gadgets have become an unavoidable factor in our daily lives. We have been able to explore all the different areas of technology in our personal, study and work lives.
Rachel, are zebras black or white?
Madison, please, not now. If you haven't noticed, we are going live. And this definitely isn't the time for your silly question.
Okay, I will ask you a reasonable question. Which was the first computer invented and by whom?
I don't know. Okay, then you tell.
I know the answer. But my friend Flixen will give us a better insight on the generation of computers.
Oh, okay. So that's what the video is about. I'm so excited. Let's find out.
Hello friends. Today we are going to discuss about generations of computer. The evolution of computers started in the 16th century, resulting in today's modern computers. It is distinguished into five generations of computers, starting from the first programmable computer to the ones based on artificial intelligence. Each generation of computer is characterized by a technological advancement that fundamentally changed the way that computers operate, resulting in smaller, cheaper, more powerful, more efficient, and reliable computing devices. Based on the various stages of development, computers can be classified into first generation computers, second generation computers, third generation computers, fourth generation computers, and fifth generation computers. First generation computers. From 1940 to 1956. They were built using vacuum tubes, which is an electronic device that controls electric current through a vacuum in a sealed cylindrical container. Such computers implemented the stored program concept. Input devices were in the form of paper tapes and punched cards. They needed a very large room and they were too bulky in size. They emitted a large amount of heat and they needed air conditioners for its working. Some of the examples of first generation computers are ENIAC, UNIVAC and ETVAC. Second generation computers from 1956 to 1963. They were built using transistors. They were more powerful and faster than the first generation computers. They were smaller and cheaper too than the first generation computers. The manufacturing cost of second generation computers was very less. They occupied very small space and they emitted less heat and also their power consumption was also very less. The concept of programming languages were introduced during the first generation computer era. High-level programming languages like COBOL and Fortran were introduced. Used magnetic core memory for primary memory and magnetic disk memory for secondary memory. Some of the examples of second generation computers are IBM 1401 and IBM 1620. Third generation computers from 1964 to 1971. They were built using integrated circuits which could embed miniature transistors. They were smaller and cheaper than the previous generation computers. Speed, power, and efficiency of computers of the third generation were increased. Multi-layer printed circuits were developed. Input devices like mouse and keyboard also were introduced. Core memory was replaced with higher efficient solid-state memories with higher capacity. One of the major developments of third generation computers are introduction or the development of multitasking, which means you will be able to run different programs at a single time. Some of the examples of third generation computers are IBM 360 and IBM 370. Fourth generation computers, 1971 onwards. They are present day computers. They are built using microprocessors, which is a small chip containing a large scale of integration circuits. And these computers are also known as microcomputers. Now, the situation is that we are able to carry our computers from one place to another without any hassle. Our laptops, desktops are examples of microcomputers. And did you know, smartphones, tablets, and even smartwatches we use are different types of microcomputers. The computers nowadays are of higher accuracy and faster processing speed. And as you all know, the present day computers are more popular, user-friendly, and also less costly. Some of the old examples of the present generation computers, that is the fourth generation computers, are IBM PC and Apple II.
In April 1975, the world's first complete pre-assembled personal computer system was introduced. It had 1 or 2 8-inch floppy disk drives, a 32-character plasma display, 80-column graphical thermal printer, 40 kilobytes of RAM, and basic language. Nowadays, either Intel's or AMD's microprocessors are being widely used. i9 9th gen is Intel's and Ryzen 2nd gen is AMD's latest powerful microprocessors.
Now that we have come to the final classification, which is
the 5th generation.
They are the future generation computers. They uses the technology of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, abbreviated as AI, is the ability to simulate human intelligence. It helps to solve complex problems. Developments in the computing machines that has the ability to recognize natural language input and speech recognition are in progress.
In the 5th generation, Ultra Large Scale Integration Technology, abbreviated as ULSI, is used, resulting in the production of microprocessor chip having 10 million electronic components. Next, we can see the different generations of software used in different generations of computers. In the 1st generation, the machine language was used. The 2nd generation used low-level programming languages such as assembly language. The 3rd generation computer used structured high-level programming languages such as COBOL and FORTRAN. The fourth generation is using non-procedural high-level programming languages such as object-oriented language. One of the main examples of object-oriented language is C++. As I said, the artificial intelligence technology is in a very great process at the era. We can find the artificial intelligence technology is being used in various sectors, especially in the medical as well as industrial sectors. Now we can see a very huge transition of AI being available to the public. There are a lot of AI engineered devices available nowadays. Let's see some of them. Number 1. Wave. Wave, in first sight, might seem to be like an ordinary modern ring, but in reality, it is an audio controller which connects to all the various devices using wireless technology. Wearing this in hands, you will be able to adjust volume, add special effects, and much more live through your hand gestures. And this is being possible through the AI technology. Number 2. Lumo. Lumo is a hoverboard, also known as a scooter bike. And the interesting thing about this hoverboard is that it is a robot with the technology of AI architecture into it. This robotic bike has various functionalities. Firstly, it is a bike which has a maximum speed of 18 km per hour. The riding experience is taken to the next level with the AI technology with face recognition and automatic tracking. Well, automatic tracking means whenever you don't want to drive, it will still follow you. And none other than you and others you assign would be able to drive or use it, which means it has a good security. Further, it can be used as a tripod, well, an advanced tripod with auto-tracking features and more. And you can achieve more with integrating your creative ideas. Number 3. M-Stick. Smart lights are available now, which can sync to your phone and can be customized by its color change. Well, M-Stick is beyond that. It's not just a smart light, but an AI-powered intelligent light. It can be used in any different way you want. Want to get notified instantly about some notifications in your phone? It can sync to your phone, and when a notification arrives, it will notify you with blinking lights and also with color changes. It also has features which will display weather information on the basis of varying colors. It can also be used behind a bicycle, which will notify other drivers about your presence in nighttime. It can also be used for taking creative selfies. Express your mood in front of it. The AI can read it and give color to the selfies according to the mood. Are you some greatest fan of somebody? Then here's a new way of expressing your feeling to them in a different and creative manner. And these are just very few capabilities of this revolutionary device. Number 4. Dating. Dating is an AI-powered smart controller watch with which you can get a very good time pass. You might have played with, or at least you might have watched, remote toy cars or other vehicles which can be controlled by your remote controller. Well, the dating remote controller is really different. Just you need, you wear it and freely show some gestures. The watch, through AI technology, reads these gestures as specific signals, and you can control your remote toys with this watch. The purchase of the product also gives you some extra toys with which you can control it to a maximum extent. This is just the beginning. A lot more has to be progressed. Once this technology can lead to a world of full automation and can lead to the progress of space science, medical science, and also the industry field.
I think this video was very informative to you. Concluding, hoping that you all will love computer science. Thank you.
Wow, I am sure that it was a very fact-filled and knowledgeable presentation. And I hope that some general knowledge has filled into your empty brain.
Very funny, Madsen. But I was thinking, since today is our first episode, and also because today is a great special day for the world of tech, shouldn't we be having a professional to talk to us more on technology?
Exactly. That is why Mr. Vibin Paul, the director of Verifone Indian Technology Private Limited, will be speaking to us more on technology.
Let's have a look on our screen.
Hello everyone. Hope you're all doing good. My name is Vibin, and today I would like to talk to you about how technology has been useful in this pandemic situation. And more interestingly, how the adoption of some of these technologies got fast-tracked. This COVID situation has been unprecedented. It has affected every one of us in one way or another. There are so many challenges in front of us. This is a story of how science and technology are helping us to make a positive impact. I work in the payment industry. We ensure that different payment transactions happen securely across the globe. The most common mode of payment is via cash, and most of you may be already familiar with your parents doing payments using cards, like credit cards or debit cards, where they will take a device, insert a card or swipe the card, enter the PIN, or you go to an ATM, enter the PIN and withdraw your cash. But with COVID restrictions, we have to minimize any physical contact and maintain social distancing, as most of these devices which you use are actually shared by thousands of other people. So here, we see the contactless technologies such as NFC driving payments using contactless cards, mobile phones, and wearable devices such as watches, where you can complete a transaction, complete the payment without having to share any device. You don't have to enter the PIN. There is biometric technologies which is used to validate you. And India has also introduced UPI-based payments, QR code-based payments, all of this ensuring that you can do transactions without having to make physical contact with the device which you share with so many other people. Let's talk about education, something that directly impacts you. Ever since the first lockdown, the way learning happens changed for around 32 crore students in India. But COVID has worked as a catalyst for the educational institutions to grow and opt for platforms with technologies which have not been used extensively before. Classroom sessions were delivered through live video conferencing using apps like Zoom, Google Meet, Google Classroom, Skype, etc. India has its own digital initiatives as well, such as Diksha, E-Pathshala, Swayam. They are basically portals and mobile apps that contain e-learning content for students, teachers, and parents aligned with the curriculum. These include video lessons, audiobooks, worksheets, textbooks, and even assessments. It has more than 80,000 ebooks for classes 1 to 12 in multiple languages, 1,900 courses covering both school and higher education. I see there are 32 DTH TV channels transmitting educational content on a 24/7 basis. There are many online courses offered free of charge by major international universities like Yale during the lockdown. This also presented amazing opportunities for people to take up these courses from the comfort of their homes. As you all know, this can never completely replace the classroom experience, but technology is helping to bridge the gap. Let's look at the global workforce. The whole work culture has changed across the world. Most people are working from home, and technology provided wonderful tools that help people to collaborate, communicate, and be productive. Sports. With COVID restrictions, I'm sure most of you must be missing playing with your friends outside. But you know, there are athletes who are not able to train outside, go out for a run or to cycle. Well, technology has brought in solutions. Now, sitting at home, you can choose any place in the world to run or to cycle or to walk virtually. Applications like Zwift, Rui, etc. provide real-life experience to sports enthusiasts. Now, to understand the impact, this year, the major marathons like New York City Marathon and London Marathon were conducted virtually. Medicine. Technology is helping to accelerate finding a vaccine for COVID. Artificial intelligence is playing an important role in suggesting components of a vaccine by understanding viral protein structures. Google's DeepMind predicts 3D structure of a protein based on its genetic sequence. We're able to create the first 3D atomic scale map of part of the virus that attaches to and infects human cells, the spike protein. So you see, technology is helping us collaborate better and fast-track remedies. Technology also helps us to process real-time data to do effective screening and contact tracing. With travel restrictions coming in, many museums around the world are providing virtual tours. With theaters shutting down, there are many streaming services for movies at home. Shopping has changed. There are many countries who are using drones to deliver goods to the customers' homes. I can go on and on. To summarize, I hope you saw how technology evolves around our needs to make this world a little better. And you, as the next generation, will do wonders with technology. I wish you all the very best. Please be safe and take care. Thank you.
Now that's something we can ponder on. Let's all think about it and do something fruitful and effective for technology to reach people around us. Wait, hold on a second.
What happened?
Our director just told me that we have our principal, Reverend Father Bino Patrakalam, coming to our show and talk us more about this day.
Wow, great. Now that's something that will add up to our joy.
Let's welcome our most humble, friendly and down-to-earth Reverend Father Bino Patrakalam to our show.
Good morning, everyone. You are watching Tech Talk and we are in conversation with the principal of Christ Nagar School, Father Bino Patrakalam. Good morning, Father. Hope you are having a very nice day, Father. So today we are here in coordination with the day, that is, today is December 2nd, and today is Computer World Literacy Day. So today we want to ask you, Father, you have had your childhood in the 20th century, and now at present we are in the 21st century. So you have seen the progress of technology, the tech world and social media. So what is your point of view in the present scenario, in this pandemic, and the progress of tech world along with it?
Now the technological world that is moving very, very faster. In our childhood days, this much opening was not there. You are blessed with lots of opportunities in the tech world, but use it in the right way. That is needed for this hour.
So Father, talking about social media, there are many problems faced by the society related to the misuse of social media. So can you tell us the best ways to use social media in the right way?
It's a good question. I experience a simplicity in that question too. Now, this tech world is open, but use it in the right way, in the right sense, that the teenagers have to learn. I think that kind of learning is not happening at home. In the school also, not properly it is being trained. So I think the coming years, that kind of training has to happen in the school and at home too. Then only the right way of right use of the social media may happen in our children.
So Father, those points are definitely to be noted. So, Father, what are the changes you see, especially in the education sector, that is both in teaching and learning, especially now as we learn in the comfort of our houses, our homes? What is the differences that you have noted? What are the comparisons that you would like to share with us?
So there is a great difference, a drastic change. I can feel it. Earlier, I was also a bit skeptical regarding the usage of technology. Now that attitude of mine also have been changed. Now the teachers, we also have changed. Now they are using, they are learning the technology, and by that they teach the children in a efficient way, and the children also learn to use in a good manner. In this scenario, I could experience the help of my parents. I'm very much thankful to my parents. I thank my parents, my teachers, and my dearest children.
So Father, how has our school contributed towards spreading technology to the underserved communities?
We are not having that much queries, but there were some queries also. The class teachers were getting, they were giving some kind of feedback to me. So I was being helped by our alumni group. So I discussed this matter with them, and for some cases they supported and they were providing. The school did not go and the school did not do, but our alumni was a great force and they were helping some children. But we couldn't do much in this time.
So Father, as we come to an end of this segment, what is the message that you would like to convey to the youth and teenagers at present?
Youth and teenagers, they have to grow as good citizens of tomorrow. They have to be productive. They have to be useful to the society and to the world. And they need to have a loyalty to their family, to the society, from which all institution they have studied. And they have to mold a good character that makes them a better or a great person. So I wish and pray let that happen in you to become a great citizens of tomorrow. And at this juncture, I would like to thank the computer department of our school for taking this initiative, for arranging this kind of interview and taking all the needed steps for it. Thank you, my dear children. Thank you, my dear teachers of the computer department.
Thank you, Father, for your valuable time.
Thank you.
That conversation definitely did boost up our spirits, Father. Rachel, what's going on? I hate it when you have that look on your face.
Well, I have a surprise for you.
What is it?
We, along with our audience, are going to watch a skit on the impact of pandemic in our lives and on how blessed we are to be living in this era where technology has progressed to such great heights.
Now that's a surprise I can't wait for. I can't wait to watch it. Let's all sit back and enjoy and experience the amazing performance by our fellow mates.
Okay, so everything clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Shreya, understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay then, students. That's all for today, and make sure you submit your assignments tonight itself, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, sure.
Okay, ma'am.
All right then, have a good day.
Thank you, ma'am. Why are we so unlucky? Our final year that we will be spending in our school, it's just gonna be over in a few months. We haven't had a single class yet, and having fun between the classes, eating snacks, without teachers knowing in the class. Good times.
finish this fast?
You call that fast?
Well, I'm used to seeing you come home late from extra class, na? That's why.
Oh, 2019 things.
Tell me, how are your classes going on? Are you catching up well?
Yeah, mom.
Good. That's my girl. You're in plus 2 now. I'm expecting 90% and above for all your subjects on your boards.
Yeah, mom. I know that. And I will. But do you ever think how bored I get? I haven't seen my friends for almost a year. And even in the class, I only see their face in a square box. And most of their videos aren't even on.
Well, let me...
Hello, my little baby. Didn't expect you to pick up the phone.
Ha, Grandpa. Amma is doing some work, so I picked up. Anyways, how are you, Grandpa?
Yes. I'm doing fine, my dear. I can't spend time with you now. I can't count on how many festivals we missed celebrating together this year.
Oh, Grandpa. Don't worry. I will come and visit you soon, okay?
Why so sad? Just normal scolding from Amma, right? You should be used to it by now.
It's not just that. Amma doesn't understand my feelings too. I too have friends. I miss them too, you know. Also, she has all the aunties from the society to talk. I don't even have friends here.
Well, don't be upset. All this will end now and... then you can lead a great life.
But how? My final year at school is almost near its end. My friends will go on their own ways after this.
Do you know how lucky you actually are?
Lucky? Me? Not the right word used here.
Ever heard of the 1957-58 pandemic?
Yeah. Heard of it in standard history lesson.
Yes. I was around that time.
But how can that be compared to this massive pandemic?
The influenza pandemic, also known as the Asian flu, killed 1.1 million people all over the world. Kind of close to COVID-19, you think?
But still, how does that make me lucky?
During those times, the only technological advancement we had was Fortran, a powerful scientific coding language that all the general public couldn't use. We were really lacking in the accuracy of news sharing. Technology was basically really underdeveloped and traveled really slow. We had to go through a lot of trouble in order to get some information about our friends or relatives.
I guess you are right.
Not only that, online platforms like Amazon, Flipkart, Greenbasket, etc. helps in providing daily necessities without even wanting you to step out of your door. You are completely safe compared to our times when we were all vulnerable to the disease until the cure was discovered. Believe me, Beta, we know it is difficult, but we have to believe in ourselves and move on. At least you can communicate with your friends and entertain yourself with many websites like YouTube, Netflix, etc. whenever you are bored.
Yes, you are right, Grandpa. We are indeed very lucky. Wow, I didn't realize this until now. It should have been really tough for you now.
Just said, we hold on. See how technology has developed. It still will. They are our backbone to development. Now, all it takes is just one phone call. And your classes are going as planned because of the video conferencing platforms developed by people. And that shows how much developed we are.
Goodbye, Grandpa. Have a nice day. Take care of yourself, okay? Bye.
got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, baby, when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. Feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh. I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. We're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm yelling you close.
Good morning, student.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Nothing I can see but you when you dance, 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 girl. Feel good creeping up on you, so just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving, so just keep dancing. Can't stop the feeling. Something magical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. Don't need no reason, don't be controlled. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that soul in my feet. Feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh. I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. More like the way we rock it, so don't stop. Under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close.
That was a feast to our eyes. We are so fortunate and blessed to be born in this era where technology has progressed so much.
Very true. Without computers, phones and other gadgets, we would never have been able to live as normal as now in spite of COVID.
Let us all pledge that we spread lights to the lives of many by providing ways to access technology in our own small ways. Maybe by collecting our unused and old gadgets and distributing it among those who don't have them, and make this world a better place to live in despite of the battle we all fight as one.